While there will be other solar eclipses visible for other parts of the world in the coming years, the next total solar eclipse to occur in the contiguous United States won't be until August 2044.
So perspective, some kids watching the eclipse today will have kids of their own by then. Wow, what a concept. Erin McElroy, live at Oaklawn Hometown Middle School to check out the big reactions from the little eclipse viewers. Erin.
Oh my gosh, we are having so much fun with these kids. When you told them that they're going to be middle-aged, when they see this again, their face just drops like horror, right? But I'll tell you, they're tweenagers, right? So if you want to get tweenagers just to go bonkers, you tell them that, number one, they're going to go outside with all their friends. Number two, they're going to wear some really cool glasses, looks like they're going to a 3D movie, and then it's going to get dark. It's a trifecta of coolness if you're a tweenager. So let's take a look. These guys have been prepping for weeks. Check out these masks they made. Okay. Pretty creative, right? Okay, so we're coming back to talk to some of these kids. This is such a cool idea, right? They kind of elevated the normal viewing mask. Yeah. Tell me what you guys were doing here.
So we used paper plates to help your face from, like, the sunglasses from falling.
Like, if you get too excited and you're jumping around, it stays on your face. It's brilliant.
It just falls off. The sunglasses are supposed to help you from, like, causing any damage to your eyes, you know, from getting blind or, like, you know, any eye problems.
Okay, I'm going to be looking for you out there. I'm going to be Batman, okay? So you come find me. Let's keep going. So they've been working on science experiments. My lovely ladies have been practicing this one. So tell me really quickly what you guys are doing here.
So in science, we're doing a demonstration of the solar eclipse. So the moon goes around the Earth, and when all three of them line up, the moon leaves a shadow on the Earth, and that's how the solar eclipse is represented.
And you saw this in 2017, but you barely remember, right? You said you hardly remember anything. So you're pretty excited?
Yeah, very excited.
Okay. All right, let's keep going, guys. We got more going on, okay? We got kids doing Lego demonstrations. They're doing artwork for the solar eclipse. All sorts of stuff going on. And I'll tell you, in about, I don't even know, 15, 20 minutes, there's going to be 1,100 plus kids on a very small corner of this lawn, all looking up towards the sky. Come on up here. I had to pick you because you haven't taken your glasses off since you arrived today.
Yeah.
What is your name?
Ezekiel.
Ezekiel, tell me, are you excited?
Yes, I'm super excited.
You're super excited.
Yeah.
You know you're going to be like a kind of old man the next time this happens, right?
Yeah.
You're going to be, you won't be as old as me, but almost, man, almost. Don't laugh that hard, okay? Don't laugh that hard, all right? So listen, I want to throw something by you. You know, like, almost 40% of people cry the first time they see a solar eclipse. Are you ready to, like, get in touch with your celestial soft side?
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
And you can, the glasses, you know, you could always cover up just in case, right? Yeah. Hide those tears, tears of joy. All right, you guys, you have your glasses. It's like what? They are ready. It's like 95% partiality and 100% excitement. We will check back in with you guys when we're out on the lot, all right? Back to you.
Erin, great stuff.
All right, and I have to give you props for wearing the eclipse earrings. Did you see those that she had on?
Heavy dose of reality. You're going to be as old as me or older the next time.